In mechanics of solids, factor of safety plays a very important role while we designing a mechanical component. As the name suggests, factor of safety is something related to the safety feature. So in this session, we will discuss the actual meaning of factor of safety and the use of factor of safety in various engineering applications. So this concept of factor of safety can be understood easily by looking into these problems. So in this question, we are supposed to design the diameter of a shaft which can carry a tensile load of 60 kN, and the material has an Young's modulus of 200 GPa and the yield stress is 300 MPa. So this is an elementary type of question in which we are going to use the basic equation of stress, which is nothing but load upon area. In this question, you might have noted that the stress which is given is the yield stress. So we have already learned that the material is going to a permanent plastic deformation or severe deformations after the yield stress is reached. So when we substitute in this equation, sigma is available, which is nothing but 300 MPa. Load is nothing but 60 kN. So we are going to substitute it in Newton by multiplying it with a factor of 1000, and the unknown parameter is d. So on solving this equation, we are going to get the value of d as 15.95 mm. This is a very simple method of solving this question. Now let us have some variation in this question. So the variation is given in this yield stress value. Suppose I am going to design the same diameter of shaft using the same load and same material with a different stress value. Let the yield stress be 150 MPa. Or you can assume it like this: we are going to design this stress using a stress value of 150 MPa. Rather than defining it as an yield stress, let us define it as a stress value of 150 MPa. Now I am designing my component of finding the diameter of the shaft using a stress value of 150 MPa. So the same stress equation is used, and what we have obtained is the diameter is 22.5 mm. Again, if you reduce the stress value to 100 MPa, the diameter is going to be 27.6. So what can be inferred from this? The simple explanation is that when you designed it at the yield stress 300 MPa, the diameter was a critical value, 15.95. That means even if the load goes beyond 60 kN, then definitely the value of stress that is going to generate within the material is 300 MPa, and if there is any further increase in this load value, definitely the material will be considered as failed, or permanent deformation will happen, or necking will happen. Thereby, the material is not suitable for any application and it is considered as a failed one. If you reduce this stress value while designing, what happened? The diameter now increased from 15.95 to 22.5. So what can be inferred from this? See, in this particular application, that means if you have designed the diameter of the shaft using an allowable stress of 150 MPa, then you have obtained the diameter as 22.5. And what we can say is that even if there is a variation in this load of 60 kN, suppose by accidentally this load has changed from 60 kN to 70 kN, still the material will not fail because there is an additional cross-section given to the material. Okay, so if the design is for 100 MPa, then again the dimension is going to increase to 27.6. That means even if there is a variation in the load due to any uncertainty, so kindly note that word, uncertainty, or unexpectedly, then even if such kind of load acts on the system, the material will or the structure will remain in application, there will not be a failure. Okay, that means when you reduce the stress value, or when you use a lower stress value for design, the cross section is going to increase. That means increased cross section has a capacity to carry more amount of load than the design load. Here, the 60 kilonewton is nothing but the design load. Design load. So even if your load goes beyond 60 kilonewton, you have a provision to withstand it because you have given some surplus cross section area. Thereby, it offers some safety. For a practical scenario, let us assume that there is a bridge we have constructed, and we have to expect, or you cannot always state that there should be 10 vehicles on this bridge, or there should be only SUVs on the bridge. You cannot always state it like that, or you cannot restrict 10 trucks to enter the bridge at a time. No, we cannot do that, because bridge is a one where in which you can expect large amount of uncertainty or uncertain loads. Sometimes there will be 10 trucks, 10 empty trucks. Sometimes there can be 10 or 11 loaded trucks. Sometimes there can be 5 trucks and 3 buses. So such kind of uncertainty will always be there in any engineering application, and our design should be incompatible with that. So this factor of safety is something which is related to this compatibility or this uncertainty. So this, in a very simple language, we can state it like this: we are designing something keeping or taking into account the uncertain loads or unexpected loads, and that is being reflected in the factor of safety. So factor of safety is defined as the yield or the ultimate stress divided by the allowable stress, right? So here the 300 is the yield stress, and the allowable stress is something like 150 megapascal. Okay, that means we are stating that we allow only up to 150 megapascal, but in actual practice the material can go or withstand even 300 or even bigger than that. But as a statement, we are stating that we are allowing only 150 megapascal, but in actual practice even it can hold a stress which is much beyond 150 megapascal, thereby offering some safety. So if you consider these two cases, what can be the factor of safety? So the factor of safety is going to be nothing but 300 divided by 150, which is equal to how much? 2. That means if you consider these two questions, the factor of safety is 2. If you consider 100, then what is the next factor of safety? Factor of safety is equal to 300 or 350, or 300 divided by 100. So the answer is going to be how much? 3. So the factor of safety is 3. So this is how we define the factor of safety, and we can say that as the factor of safety increases here, or as the factor of safety increases, if the factor of safety increases, what is the physical change that we cannot, the dimension is going to increase. That is how we are going to do it. So hereafter, when you look into some problems or when you go to some design, definitely we are not going to design it for the yield stress value, because designing at something near to yield is a very critical design. Always we are going to limit our stresses to some particular values so that the material will be safe even if there is an uncertain load which is going to act on the system. Okay. Now moving forward, there are two types of factors, which is nothing but one is a design factor and another one is a safety factor. So safety factor, we have already discussed how much the designed part actually will be able to withstand. That means even if you design it for 22.5, it can actually withstand a stress of some 300 or 400 megapascals. That is how the safety factor works. It actually can withstand. To find out the actual stress value, you use this diameter D, you use this load P, and you find the sigma value. That is the actual stress value it can withstand. So that is a safety value. Now what is a design factor? Stress item is required to be able to withstand. It is nothing but the stress that is allowed or stated. It is defined for an application. That means you define the factor of safety, and we say that this bridge is allowed to withstand 150 megapascal or 500 megapascal. So it is purely based on some code, standards, something like that. And the design load being the maximum load, the part should ever see in the service. That means if you have a design factor, you are not allowed to make that particular part or component to work beyond that particular load. Even if the material may withstand, but you are not allowed to do that. That is the difference between design factor and safety factor. Now let us see what are the various factor of safety is used in different applications. For buildings, commonly used factor of safety is 2. And for structural members like bridges and all those things, the commonly used factor of safety is 2. For the pressure vessels, the factor of safety used is 3.5 to 4. In automobiles, we use 3. And when we consider the aircraft, that is a very also aerospace application, this is something very serious. We may feel that the in aerospace, the factor of safety used is much higher because the parts that is used is very critical. But the problem associated with this is that even if you go for a higher factor of safety, definitely the size is going to increase. If you have a higher size, definitely you require more effort to take this particular aerospace component into space. So that is not advisable. So there in aerospace applications or aircraft or aerospace application, definitely we have to go for a negotiation with the factor of safety and the strength. That means usually it is expected to have a higher factor of safety because large amount of uncertain loads can be expected in aerospace or aircraft applications. But if we go for a higher factor of safety, definitely the size of the compound is going to be very higher. So what is the compensation or how we can negotiate on this? Negotiation happens at the design of materials. That means we need some better material or high quality material or high strength material for using it in aerospace and aircraft applications. So material development itself is a very important thing when we go to the aerospace application. When we compare with the automobile industry or the building materials, the material design is very important in the case of aerospace application just because of this particular reason. So generally the factor of safety adopted is 1.5 in the case of aerospace applications. And for pressurized fuselages we use 2 as the factor of safety, and for landing gears it is 1.25. So these are the factors that you should consider when you go for the design. And if in the question, if they state that the yield stress is some 400 megapascal and the factor of safety is 4, then definitely you have to solve the problem taking into account the allowable stress. Allowable stress is nothing but the ultimate stress divided by the factor of safety. That is how you are supposed to design it. So kindly make a note of all these range of factor of safety. So as an engineer, you should know what are factor of safety, what is the physical significance of factor of safety, and what are the general range of factor of safety that is being used. So always it is better to use the factor of safety while we design some components. So these are the references that I have used. So feel free to ask any kind of question regarding any of the topic that we have discussed here. Thank you.